गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द वीडियो लेक्चर रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर सब्जेक्ट. इन दिस वीडियो विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ग्राफ ट्रेवर्सल मेथड, स्पेशली द ब्रेथ फर्स्ट सर्च. दीज आर द कोर्स आउटकम्स ऑफ अवर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर सब्जेक्ट. एज यू ऑल नो, ग्राफ इज अ इंटरकनेक्शन ऑफ वर्टाइसेस एंड द एडजेस, एंड वी कैन विजिट ऑल द एडजेस एंड वर्टाइसेस यूजिंग द डिफरेंट ट्रेवर्सल मेथड्स. In graph traversal methods, basically there are two types. First one is known as breadth first search, second is known as the depth first search. So in this video we'll discuss about the breadth first search. So the breadth first search algorithm traverses a graph in breadth wise fashion. It uses Q to remember to get the next vertex to start a search when a dead end is reached or when it comes to an end of the iteration. The breadth first search technique is performed on the given graph by using the following rules. Rule 1 says, visit adjacent unvisited vertex, mark it visited, then display it. Whatever you have marked, you have to display it. Then insert that node into the queue. Rule 2 says, if no adjacent vertex is found, remove the first vertex from the queue. Rule 3 says, repeat rule 1 and 2 until queue is empty. So these are the three steps which are used in the breadth first traversal on the given graph. In this slide we have an example given, a graph consisting of the source vertex S, and it is connected to three neighboring vertices A, B, C. They are in turn connected to a node G or a node vertex D. Now we have to perform the traversal of this graph using breadth first search technique, BFS technique. For this we are making use of a queue. As shown in the figure, we initialize the queue to be empty and graph is represented by S, A, B, C and D vertices. Then in the second step, as the first rule of the algorithm says, we have to start visiting from the starting node. So here in this graph we are considering the starting node as vertex S and we mark it as visited. Next step, we see that unvisited adjacent node from S. Okay, so we check for how many unvisited adjacent nodes are there for S. There are three nodes, they are A, B, C. So in this example the three nodes are there with the name A, B, C. Alphabetically we choose A and we mark it as visited and we add that visited node onto the queue. Okay. Then we see next unvisited adjacent node from S. The adjacent node from S is after A, we have B. So we mark it as visited. And according to the rule, we add it to the queue. So in the figure, we can see that the queue contains two nodes. So the first vertex is A, second vertex is B. After node B, we check for next unvisited adjacent node from S, which happens to be C. Then we mark the node vertex C as visited and we add that C to the queue. So the queue contains now three vertices A, B, C as shown in the figure, upper figure. Then we have finished all the three adjacent nodes of S. Now we go for the removal of first node from the queue. So A is deleted from the queue. Then we find the adjacent nodes for A which are unvisited. So we find that from the figure we find that D is the only node which is adjacent to A and it is not visited. Unvisited adjacent node for A is D. So we mark the node D as visited and we add that node or the vertex D to the queue. So as we can see in the upper figure, A is removed from the queue and Once we remove, we find the adjacent unvisited nodes of A. We find only one vertex D, and that is marked as visited, and it is added to the queue. So we finished all other adjacent nodes. So at this stage, we are left with no unmarked or unvisited nodes. But as per the algorithm, we keep on dequeuing until we get all the unvisited nodes. When the queue gets emptied, the program is over, and we can see that the final BFS graph is shown in the figure. So from the starting vertex S, we have three unvisited nodes A, B, C, which are visited. Then we find one unvisited node A, one adjacent node for A, D, which is unvisited, then that is also visited. So we stop the process. So the final BFS graph of the given graph is shown in the figure. From the figure, it is clear that all the nodes and vertices, all the nodes or the vertices are visited only once. Thank you, students. So this is how we perform the graph traversal known as BFS on the given graph. In the next video, we will discuss about the depth first search technique. Thank you, students.